part of the material, and then we're going to have you watch video and make some decisions and explain your decisions and make us all believe you. All right. Let's go real quickly just to review a couple things so we're all on the same page. Three conditions for a foul to occur. What's the first one?
Player.
Has to be committed by a player. Good. What else?
Ball in play.
Ball in play, and you get the last one. What were you going to say?
It has to be committed against a player on the other team.
Okay, so we got that committed by a player. We got the opponent guard as well. In play and on the field in play. Good. So we have to have these conditions. Right? They all have to be met for it to be considered a foul. If one of those is not met, it may still be misconduct, but it can't be a foul. Okay, so we just have to kind of get that terminology straight in our minds a little bit. Okay, our direct free kick fouls. So we have the seven. These are the ones we're going to focus on today because they're the ones that have a severity component. So what are our three levels of severity? First one is the lowest. Careless, very good. One in the middle, good. And the last one? Excessive force. I have no name, so heads up. Types of fouls here. Go ahead and yell them out. The K stands for good. Striking, excellent. You're gonna get both talks today. C. Charging, good. P. Pushing, and the last team. Good. So if this is dripping, what's that one? Tackle. Excellent. Do we have to know these right off by heart? Right off the top of our head. Kick, trip, jump, strike, charge, push, tackle. Boom, 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 boom. Your doctor, that's your anatomy. Okay, so we have to know these, for sure, for sure. Okay, our three levels of severity are careless, that's just a simple foul, blow the whistle and point, hopefully the correct direction. If we say reckless, or we say yellow card or cautionable, those all mean the same thing. Okay, so we're going to interchange those terms. And if we say excessive force or send-off or red card, all of those things mean the same thing as well. So if you say this is a reckless challenge, automatically we have to think reckless is yellow. Say this uses excessive force, we have to automatically think that means red. Okay, we all good? Okay, so just quick review. The other three fouls are what? They don't have a severity component. They are, don't give away all the answers today.
Spinning,
good. Do you have your hand up, huh? What did you say? Spinning, all right, awesome. Yep.
Gestures.
It has to be in the book under fouls. With spinning. We have handling, very good. And our third one? Is it one of the fouls? Go ahead. No, we have holding, we have handling. Okay, open up the law book at the last resort. Open up the law book and see what it says. Holding. We have holding. Okay? So holding, handling, spinning. These are the other three of the 10 direct free kick fouls. They just have to happen. Okay? You can't hold somebody in a reckless manner. You can't spit at somebody with excessive force. Right, we've seen how this goes, so if we back up, right? These are severity, so it can be careless, reckless, excessive force. Holding, handling, spitting, they either happen or they don't. Okay, do we have that straight in our minds? When you do see misconduct go with it, it's because it's either a tactical foul or dog sick for holding and handling. It has nothing to do with the severity. That's a tactical component that comes with it. Okay, we're going to set that aside today. We're not going to talk about that today. All we're going to talk about is the severity. Careless, reckless, excessive force. Okay? So here's our motto. All around the world, green means?
No.
Green means?
No.
Good. So we have no foul all agree. As we come up, we have kind of robust play. Maybe not a foul yet, but starting to get our attention. As we come up, we have a foul, blow the whistle and point. The careless foul. As we start coming up, this is where a lot of refereeing happens. So yes, we have a foul, but maybe we have a little extra something in there. That makes us either have a quiet word with the player. Hey, your timing's a little off. You know, let's clean that up. Have a public word with the player. Number four, zip. Or a public admonishment where we have a very good, productive meeting of the minds with the referee. That everybody gets to see. Okay, so sometimes we have a plus. And when we have these things, we're just to the left of caution. This is where a lot of refereeing happens. Most of it happens just before, is it really a foul? Just before, is it really a caution? And again, just before, is it really a send-off? That's where a lot of the refereeing happens. Okay, so what elevates contact to a foul? What makes something trifling versus, yeah, I have to blow my whistle here? Excellent. Help you wait for you. So does it have a material effect on the play? And we're going to get to that in a second. Really, it depends. That's going to change a little bit, right? What if it has a material effect on the play? Is it different if it's a U5, U8, or U19, or professional, or amateur? There's a difference, right? In terms of does it matter? What else can it depend on? Skill set. So you may have U13 and U13, but maybe one game has a very high skill level, the other game, call it still developing, right? So what materially affects the play is gonna be a little bit different for those, even though they're the same age. What else?
Advantage. Advantage, is there advantage?
So we're asking what makes something trifling versus a foul. If we have advantage, then we actually have a foul that's occurred, right? That we're not called. But we're here, so we've got age, we've got the skill level. What about the context of the game? How many of us have done some kind of playoff something? So anything. Do we call it the same way as we do the very first or second game of the season? What's our main rivalry here in the area? Teams that are big rivals. Who is it?
Valley and Dowling.
So in those two plays, do we call the same types of fouls as we do in other games? We adjust, right? So it depends maybe on the context. Good. So these are going to depend. Is it trifling? So our key question is just like our gentleman said here, does it have a material effect on the play? If it does, go ahead and blow your whistle and point, hopefully in the correct direction. If it doesn't, then we keep going. This is going to carry you from the U-littles all the way up to international. We ask the same question. So at the professional level, you see a lot of illegal contact not get called. It's because it doesn't have a material effect on the play. That's why we let it go. As long as the players are kind of on board with it. And if they're not, then it'll have material effect on the play really quickly. So we asked what elevates contact to a foul. Now we're going to get into a little bit what elevates a foul to misconduct. So we have six elements. We're going to focus on four of them during the videos. I'm going to give you the first one.
Result.
Point of contact is our first element that we have to look at. And that's both from the victim, right, who's taking the challenge, and from the perp, who's giving it out. Who's dishing it out, who's taking it. So for the victim, you have to know and see, you have to be able to see what part of the body did they take contact on. And we have to be specific here. It can't just be lower body. It can't just be, I don't know, somewhere in the middle. Was it the thigh? Was it the calf? Was it the ankle? Was it the knee? Was it the face? Was it in the spine? Or was it at the shoulder? We have to be specific. So you're looking at the videos, really hone in on what point of contact took the contact, actually. And from the perp, what did they use to make this contact? Because forearm is different than elbow. Laces are different than cleat. So these things make a difference because they're going to make a difference where we come up on our severity. So we really have to zoom in on that. Second one is direction. Okay, what's another one? We'll get into that one a little bit.
Force,
good. And what comes into force? Speed, excellent.
Distance.
And distance, very, very good. So those two things are going to give us a sense of the amount of force. We have a couple exceptions we're going to look into. What's another one?
Position on the field.
Potentially. The timing of the contact. Okay. There's our severity. We talk a little bit about motive in there, and we're going to talk a little bit about the result. Everything when we talk about the video or when you talk about the video has to start with I see. You say, I think, I feel. You have to wear the I think hat.
Is that the visual one?
It is. So a song comes with it or a knock knock joke. So everybody's been warned. We start our sentences with
I see.
Nobody's wearing the hat yet. I'm wondering if this class can make us a good knock knock. Alright, so let's go through here real quick. Point of contact. Tent we have somewhere in the ankle. To start with, let's assume that the ball is on the ground. Okay? And then look at the point of contact in relation to the ball being on the ground. So if it's down, if it's really right on the ankle, potentially that could be more severe, but if it's kind of down low and the ball is on the ground, where are we on our severity? It's kind of lowish, right? So if the ball is on the ground and the point of contact is at the knee or the thigh, what happens to our severity? Now we're starting to come up in here, right? That's going to be a big visual cue that's up at the thigh or the knee area. Quite often, that pushes us up to a yellow card, to a reckless type of challenge. Okay, again, assuming the ball is on the ground. Now what happens? Ball's on the ground. Contact is way up here. What does that do to our severity? We have some other things going on too, right? Because we have the point of contact from the perp coming into play as well. So especially if you put these two things together, where's our severity? It goes up very quickly. Okay, so you have to be able to zoom out to be able to see not only the point of contact, but where is it in relation to the ball. Okay? But there, it's like, well, the ball was in. Okay. So what happens if we reverse it? If the ball is up high, the contact now comes in down low on the legs. Our severity still comes up, right? Because they're far away from each other. So if you tell me I was going for the ball there, I know you're lying. Like, that's a good story, but I'm not buying. All right, direction. We have three things. I want to get to the video relatively quickly. So first one is from the side. Where are we in severity with it if it's coming from the side? Left or right? Leftish. Good. Okay, what's another option?
Behind.
From the front? Good. And this one kind of depends, right? So to put us on the left side of the spectrum, what does a front end tackle have to look like? Studs are down, good. Leg is? Yep, got low to the ground. I heard it over here. Leg is what?
Bent.
Right, that's going to pull the force away. Coming in, and then if you're David Beckham, where does this type of tackle put us on the spectrum?
Right.
Right, and what's the difference?
Straight leg.
Straight leg. cleats up.
Over the ball.
Right, so also over the ball, which is not helpful, which means you're probably not terribly interested in it. Okay, so from the, when it comes from the front, we really have to look very closely. Are the cleats down? Is the leg bent? Is there a little space in front? Or do I have them coming in? Straight leg, cleats up, over the ball. Makes a big difference as to what side of the spectrum we're on. Okay. From behind, generally left or right, left or right, left or right?
Right.
Right, very good. Because this is the one that bugs everybody. Okay. Player can't see it, can't see the tackle coming in, they can't prepare themselves for it. Okay, so now we're starting to get the hang of this. Each of these elements has its own little mini spectrum in it. It's going to push us one way or the other. Timing of the contact. What are our options?
Early.
Early, before the ball comes. Good.
On time.
On time. And looking out the third one on this side of the room.
Late.
Late. Which one bugs people the most?
Late.
Yeah, good job. So before the ball arrives, maybe here, unless you're about to put your elbow in somebody's nose, in which case, that could go to the other side. As the ball arrives, what side of the spectrum? Leftish, right? This is going to be leftish. Good. After the ball is gone, which side of the spectrum?
Right.
Closer to the right. Very good. Good. And
we're
going to break away. That's kind of a big different motivation. So you guys already went through this. Force is the distance plus the speed. We have, again, our own little mini spectrum. Coming through, short distance, slow speed. We're on the left side of the spectrum. As we get higher distance, higher speed, coming up from far away at a fast speed, now we're towards the right of the spectrum. We have a couple of exceptions in here where we still have very high force, but a small distance and not necessarily a lot of speed. There's two types of tackles. Let's think lower body for the moment.
Scissors.
Scissor tackle, excellent. Where are you? What's another type?
Slide.
Yep. Go ahead.
Slide.
Maybe a slide, that could be good, but we're talking about the type of tackle. Very specific one, if I can find my thing. Very specific one that comes up in here.
2 foot tackles.
Those 2 foot, and what is it about those 2 footed tackles? What do we see?
Right.
Yeah, there's, yeah, studs are up.
Launching.
They're getting air under them. They don't need a lot of speed to get that. Don't need a lot of distance. They're getting up in the air and launching or lunging themselves towards the opponent. There's no control. So you'll generally see both feet off the ground. In these, leg is often straight. Studs are often exposed. Get up off the ground, no control. These don't have to start from very far away in order to have a lot of force associated with it. Same with the scissor tackle. You don't need a lot of speed, you don't need a lot of distance to make these very, very destructive and have a very high amount of force. Okay, so keep those in mind as your exceptions to that speed and distance. We good? Understand, we're all together? So the motive may actually be to play ball.
So.
Every now and again, it might actually be. Another motive might be to intimidate. What type of player, generally, what position on the field do these types of players tend to occupy?
Center back
a little bit, but they have to be careful.
Defensive
midfielders, excellent. Right? These are the ones who say, you might as well go try the other side of the field, because this is what you're going to get all game long on my side of the field. And they're those little tackles that just kind of constantly want to intimidate. So they're always going to float around this kind of blue-ish, just pushing the envelope, right? Foul plus. They're going to do anything that really gets them a yellow card early, but they're just going to hassle them. So defensive midfielders, very good. Motivation may be to stop play. Motivation may be to retaliate or injure. Ball is here. How much interest in the ball when the tackle is here? Not a lot of interest in the ball. So you can start asking yourself, what kind of tackle can I expect? What kind of challenge can I expect based on their system of play, based on the player role, based maybe on the history of the teams and their tactics? This can come into play. This type of foul might be low. If it triggers retaliation, where's my retaliation going to land? Lower or higher?
Higher.
Always higher. This is going to be the get off me elbow. About 2 seconds. Right, this is the total mass confrontation. Generally, once that those tackles that promote mass confrontation, where are they on the spectrum? They're high, right? When the players get very, very upset. Okay, so we're gonna watch some video. We'll play the videos twice. Go ahead and write down your decision. Jot down a couple of things with our elements of the amount of force or severity, the timing, the point of contact, and the direction. And use those things to come to your final decision.
Are we going to watch a video to discuss it, or
watch? We're going to watch about 5 or 6 videos, and then we're going to go back and discuss each one. Okay? So we really want to start practicing now that we've gone through all the elements. Let's practice thinking in that way. If you start doing that on the field, you'll get better and better at it, and it'll come more and more quickly. It's going to give you some consistency and some clarity in your thought process. And then if players or coaches come at you and say, why is it this and not this? You have in your mind, boom, boom, boom. And they may still think we're wrong, but they're more likely to believe us because we have a very clear train of thought that makes sense. Okay, thoughts on using some professional game video. We use it because we have it. That's the bottom line. Do not worry about what the referee is doing. The referee is doing a heck of a job, first of all. Second of all, the clip is taken out of context. So if there is a yellow card shown, we don't know if the referee is actually giving it for that particular challenge or potentially for persistent infringement. Okay, so don't make any assumptions as to why the misconduct is being shown. What are the core features that you see? And base your decision on those features and then bring them into your game. Okay. We have a couple main differences between youth matches, amateur, and professional. Any ideas?
Speed
of play is the big one. Everything, it happens very similarly, just much more quickly.
Skill
level, which means how many accidents are there at the professional level?
Zero.
Not a lot. I don't say zero, I give them a little bit of benefit, not quite that cynical. But very unlikely. There's a lot fewer accidents. All right, let's start up. Let's see that one more time, okay? Just like the
middle again, too many Houston jerseys there. Washington with a soft touch. Now Ojai, closed off quickly by King. King looking to push forward. Soft touch for Reeves. As Klingenberg stays down, and that's not good news for Houston.
this is in two stages. You're going to see live on this frame and then the replay. This is the first one, the first view. And here's the replay. We'll show you the first one again, okay, so you can see the full view. Here's from the other angle.
When we saw in the game against Houston, she subbed in late in that half, so once again getting the last couple minutes in this game.
Well, the disappointing part is you have to bring Rebecca Moros out of the game, who was so strong on the attack off that wing in the first half, but not really a lot of pace for her in the second half, and she sort of fell off the wagon.
Only 7 minutes in, Tommy.
Well, this is a very dangerous. Looking challenge. He comes in, and yep, he has the stud showing.
Baldomero Toledo had no hesitation whatsoever. And the first thing you saw out of his pocket was red.
Yeah, he never hesitated. Let's get a better look at it. Here it's a very dangerous looking challenge.
So you remember it, and then we'll talk. Okay, so everyone remembers that's what we're talking about, right? All right, everybody close your eyes. Close. No cheating. Close your eyes. You have no foul, put up your hand. Well, feels a little strange now, doesn't it? Okay. I thought we were good. If you have just a foul, simple foul, careless foul, put up your hand. Yellow card, put up your yellow card or your phone. And red card. All right, open your eyes. We as a group have everything from, boom, no foul, to, boom, red card.
We always do.
I swear to you.
We always do.
You have it on camera. So if you wonder why we drive coaches batty, this is one of the reasons. Okay, so we have to, as a room, come together a little more. Okay? We cannot have some of us with no foul and others sending the player off. And of course, I've lost. So I know who you are. You know who you are. If you had no foul, go ahead and volunteer yourself and walk. Talk us through what you saw. Don't make me volunteer you. No foul, people. Go on. We're with family. It's okay. No foul, people. We saw some. No? That someone at the back? Someone at the back? Okay, we're gonna see this. We had just a careless foul. All right, go.
I'm not happy
with the no foul people. Go on.
I saw.
Good start.
The player come together, the defender come together with her legs to try and block the ball, but she did not play the player at all.
Okay, I'm gonna stop you there for a second. Let's go with our core elements. Okay, point of contact.
Was it the thigh?
Was it thigh, and where was the ball?
At the feet.
At the feet. Okay, so where for point of contact are you on with your spectrum?
I'm between blue and yellow.
Okay. Direction of contact?
In front.
From the front, so where are you in your spectrum?
Between green and blue.
Okay. Timing?
It was as the ball was there.
As the ball was there? So whereabouts are you?
Same place, about blue.
Talk a little bit about motive.
She did not try to play the player. She tried to play the ball with the block.
But missed.
Feet down.
But missed. Okay. So that's how you came. So I like the thought process. There's clarity in it. All those elements that you're talking about, what you saw, you come to a logical conclusion with it. Okay, good. So hold that thought. Who had a red card? Yep. Anybody else have red? A couple of us. There was someone at the back here who also had red. Okay, we're going to hold that thought just for a moment. Yellow? All right. You had your hand most enthusiastically raised, young man.
Okay, so I saw
good.
It the sides above the ball, and then I also saw that she was coming in, and she was a bit past the halfway line, I saw.
Okay, so point of contact. Where did she make contact with her opponent?
She made contact with her opponent, about a foot above the ball, near the thighs.
Near the thighs? So where are you in your spectrum?
I would put that at a yellow.
Good. And how about the direction that she came in?
So she was moving to her left at the time she got fouled, and she was coming in.
So front, side, or back?
From the side.
Side, where would you put that?
Between blue and yellow.
Good. Okay, and how about the timing? Did she get there before the ball was there? Did she get the ball? Or was it after the ball was gone?
So I saw that she was coming in a bit early.
A bit early, okay. And where would you put that?
So I put that yellow again.
Yellow? Good, so from those things you came up with?
Yellow.
Yellow. How about that for a thought process? Anybody? Okay, ready? Heads up. Oops, that's stuck in my hand. Sorry. Anybody have different thoughts in terms of what they saw? Anything a little different? What did you have, young person?
I saw that after, like, they actually that I think one person in the red team, after they did it, they sort of did this to the person, and then the
okay.
And the white team ran against.
Ran into her. Very good. So you saw the red player come in, and then the white player go into her. Excellent. What else? Anything else that we have? Good job. Good. Any other thoughts on what we saw? Timing? So more of us had late rather than early, right? And where would you put that? Still with the yellow. Good. So let's take a quick look at it. And do some verification. Okay, so definitely from the front, kind of side-ish, but from the front. I'm going to pause it at the point of contact. Nutmeg. So even if she gets a toe on the ball here, is that enough? Everybody shake your head no. Okay, it's not enough. She's coming into her path, and the point of contact here is very high compared to the ball. She's using the speed of the player to kind of elevate that force a little bit. She doesn't have a lot of speed on her own, but she's going into the path of the player who has control of the ball and is trying to maintain control of the ball. So all of those things, speed and distance, yeah, here, but everything else, here. So we would be looking for a yellow card for a reckless challenge on this one. Okay, so we're going to go to the next one, go a little bit faster. Okay? Close your eyes. No foul, put up your hand. Simple foul, put up your hand. Yellow card, put up your yellow card. And red card, put up your red card. All right, open your eyes. We are everywhere from a foul to red card. Okay, so still some variability in the room. We're going to, again, pull ourselves together a little bit. Okay, so let's go with the extreme. Red card people, we had some up front. All right, I like how you enthusiastically go with your decisions. Make me believe you some.
So it was behind the person, so the person could not prepare themselves, and the person was in front of the ball.
So from challenge was from behind, and where does that put you on the spectrum?
Red.
Okay. Timing, before the ball was there, as the ball arrived, or after the ball was gone?
He was dribbling the ball, so I would say at the right
what
time.
What did you see?
But the player was in front of the ball, so...
Timing of it, before the ball was there, as the ball was there, or after the ball was gone? You have to pick one.
As it was there.
As it was there? Okay, so where are you on the spectrum for that?
That would be like bluish.
Okay. Put it there. So we had point of contact. What did he use? What did he make contact with?
It was the lower body, so probably around the ankle.
So make contact with the ankle and not the ball. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, yes. So where are you on the spectrum?
That would be like orange.
Orange. So are you still comfortable with your red card, even though you have a couple of things, one thing really low?
Yes, I would give them an orange card.
You're giving them an orange card? Well done. All right, hold that thought. Who had no foul? Yes, the one waving his hand enthusiastically in a burgundy sweatshirt. That'd be you.
Okay.
Make me believe you.
I saw...
Good. Nobody's wearing the hat. Okay, go ahead.
Player slided, and the timing was on, like, good on time.
Good on time. So where are you here? Green. Good. direction?
Direction.
Direction of the challenge? Did it come from the front, from the side, or from behind?
The side.
From the side, so where are you here?
Between green and blue.
Still green, good.
And the contact was at the person's feet, was at the attacker's feet.
And what did they make contact with?
They made the contact with the ball.
So the ball, yeah, by kind of, that's about all you can hope for, right? Any follow through that was problematic after they got the ball?
No.
No? So you have no foul? Corner kick. Okay? Okay, so let's take a look. And on thought process, where are we in our process? Good job. Let's do a verification. Oh, sorry. Trying to pause it there. One more time. Yeah, this one will work. Okay, the trajectory of the ball is following that of the challenger, correct? So is the person who's making the challenge, are they in front of the player, coming into the player, or are they behind the player? Where's the leg that's making the contact with the ball? In front. Right? It's in front. The ball is in front of the person dribbling. Okay, so the leg making contact with the ball is in front of the player. Okay? Everything else about it is very reasonable. When's the ball? Trajectory of the ball goes in the same direction as they do. It's from the side. Timing is good. Is they getting the ball? Making contact with the ball, so we have no foul. Okay? We have no foul. This player in blue just goes over the legs afterwards. And there's not a back leg that comes in and sweeps them out, or scissors, or anything like that. It's just the leg is bent, and it's a natural follow-through movement with a reasonable amount of force to get the ball. Okay? Okay, next one. Hey, we all remember this one? Replay right quick. Okay, close your eyes. No foul. Foul. Yellow card, red card. Open your eyes. But to be fair, very few here, the vast majority were here with a few here. So even though we joke that we are from here to here, we actually got a lot more consistent on this one because we were centered here. We have very much critical mass, so good. That's going definitely going in the correct direction. Okay, who had just a simple foul? Yep, go.
Well, it was a little early.
So contact before the ball was there?
Yeah, I put that.
Okay, so where are you on the spectrum?
Between blue and yellow.
Okay. Timing? Sorry, direction?
Well, it's to the side, so I put that between blue and yellow as well.
Okay.
Amount
of force? Yep, we're point of contact.
Is that much force?
Good, so where would you put force?
Blue.
Blue, good. And point of contact?
Well, there's all full body contact, so I'm not sure exactly where I put that.
Can you narrow it down for me?
Shoulder against shoulder.
Shoulderish and?
And hips.
And with the women, if they go shoulder to shoulder, almost by definition, they are hip to hip. We're just kind of built that way. So that's where you're getting that full body contact a little bit. So shoulder to shoulder will come along with it. Where are you putting it?
More yellow,
and so you came with here, right?
Yes.
So you're going to have a little bit of a meeting of the minds or a little chit-chat?
Yeah.
With your foul? All right, I can buy that. Thought process? Clap-a-meter? And who had yellow card?
Okay, we only had a few of those. I'm going to get you on the next one because I want to watch, do a little bit more video. But that was so well done that we're going to stick with that. Here we would look for a foul. If in your game, in the youth game, that kind of force comes up a little bit, if you think, hey, in the context of what we have, that's reckless, if you give the yellow, you would be supported. At the professional level, yellow might be a little bit harsh for it, but if the referee made me believe them, I would also support a yellow here. It's right in that kind of gray, it's right in here, isn't it? So it may depend on some of the other things going on in that game. If it's really, really quiet, and this is the first thing that happens, maybe we chit-chat. If it's getting chippy, or this player has a tendency doing this, and we've already chit-chatted, now we can step up. Okay, quick one and two. Yep?
Was it a little bit tactical? I mean, where was that on?
I don't think so. It's an attacker doing it to a defender. So I think she is interested in trying to turn the ball over, and she just got her out of the way a little bit beforehand. Yep.
I just want to make it clear that the hip check really is not shoulder to shoulder.
This one leads with the hip, but there's shoulder contact as well. But it leads with the hip.
Oh, yeah, what you mean?
That's where we're strong. That's where we're strong. All right. Good. Okay, next one. You guys are good. Thought process is coming along nicely. Okay, close your eyes. Close your eyes, close your eyes. This is the only honest way to do it. Sit here, otherwise you're gonna look around. Hey, no foul. Simple foul. Yellow card. Red card. Good, open your eyes. We had a couple of people with no foul, very, very few. One person with a red card. Everybody else, vast majority was yellow card. Second place with a foul. So you're doing well. Minimum foul. Minimum. We cannot have no foul here. Can someone tell me why we have to have at least a foul? Stop me when you see it. Okay, so maybe that first foot gets the ball, potentially. We have to look at the rest of the contact. And I think that's what's pulling people towards just a foul or no foul. But when you look at the back leg coming in, what's it doing? It's sweeping quite a bit. This is our, like the polite version of a scissors. Right? It doesn't have that force like a cigar cutter. But that's a lot coming in, and it's a lot more force than is needed for her to win the ball here. So she's putting herself through the player. What's the direction of the contact? And where would we put that from behind? We're at least in here, yeah? At least? How about here-ish? So we already have from behind, and what's that back leg doing? So point of contact is where on the player, receiving it. Right, that's coming up a little bit higher towards the knee because that front part is kind of pinned in, and that follow through is causing that contact to be high. So where are we going to put that? Down here?
No.
Stop me?
Yeah.
So we've already got two of our elements up here. We can't go all the way down here. Does that make sense? So now we talk about from behind. We talk about the amount of force and her speed. Where would you put her speed? Up here?
No.
Down here?
No.
Yeah. Ish. Yeah? Ish. So we're already ish here. Speed and distance. We're here on the direction and the amount of force. So where do you think we would want to lean towards? This is a solid yellow. A lot of it because of the direction she's coming from. Okay? And the amount of force that she's using. Good. Good, getting better. If it's just a foul, you
I hope there better be a baptism with it. But honestly, at no level do I see this not getting a yellow card. Do we want 22 players committing these kinds of tackles around the field? Be comfortable giving a second yellow for this? I would too. It borders on not being soccer. Right? Dangerously close to not being soccer anymore. Good. We've got time for one more. Is this our assassin one? No, it's not. That was boring.
Sandra, if you want to take an extra minute or two, we can let the other groups go to lunch.
Honestly, I'm supposed to tell you that when you come back from lunch, it has to be at 110, not 120.
In the auditorium.
And you're in the auditorium. Thank you. Okay, do you want to do the boring one quick? Can we do this quickly?
You can.
How many have no foul? Did she get the ball?
Yes.
Did she get the ball here? She got it now. If I push her out of the way, I can get the ball. Yeah. So the player in white's getting the ball before making contact with the opponent?
No.
Thank you. So almost by definition, we can't be here. Right? Direction? Go behind. Amount of force? Men. Right? So, enough for a yellow card for being reckless? Are we comfortable here? No, nobody's up here?
No.
Okay. So that's point, blow the whistle, point, be like, really? Trust no female at any level. Okay, close your eyes. Let's see. Finish this one strong. Finish this one strong. How many have no foul? Put up your hand. Good. What game do you want? How many have red card? How many have less than a red card? Okay, put up both hands if you have less than a red card and change it to a red. And open your eyes. We had one person fooling around with no foul. I'm not exactly sure what your game looks like. We're all okay up to here. What part of soccer is that?
She's trying to run. She's in the way of the ground, really.
So with an acre and a half of field,
yes.
She's 2 square inches of space,
yes.
Where the player's thigh happens to be. And the idea of, let me see if I can find the grass. Oh, that's over there. Let me look before I step. Because that's important to make sure I get.
She's in the way.
How many think this is an accident? This is not an accident. Okay, bonus question. Bonus question. Congratulations, nobody wore the hat. All right. Who wants to explain what category of red card this is going to be? Your options are serious foul play, or violent conduct? Want to say violent conduct? Good. Who wants to walk me through why? You got this? Are you unsure? You got it? You got it? All right. Hit me.
Because she's messing around and stuff was on an accident when she's definitely
climbed
over her and she hit her in
the
groin.
Okay, she stepped on her, so why is it violent conduct and not serious foul play? What's the element that's missing
not to be a serious foul play. What about the ball?
It's not there.
Ball is not there, so she is not?
Not trying to get the ball.
She's not trying to challenge for the ball. Right? So, because she's not challenging for the ball at the time, go ahead.
She's trying to hurt the other girl.
She did. You think she succeeded?
Yeah.
The difference between why it's violent conduct and not serious foul play is that she's not challenging for the ball. And the ball is in play, it's on the field of play, and it's committed by a player. So yes, we do have a foul. However, because the ball is so far away and she's not challenging for it, it becomes violent conduct. We have to get that difference correct when we write up our reports. If you're not sure what category, then that's when we pick up the phone. You call Terry, or you call Chip, or you call someone and say, here's what I saw. How do I write this out? And if you can be accurate and specific with what you saw, you will always come to that good conclusion. Very good on the thought process. It's very well done. We came much, much closer together as a group, which warms my heart. We can still have a little bit of fun driving home to Scotty, but other than that, you did great. Well done, you guys.
We're born into this world, we're thrown like a dog without a bone, an actor out on loan, riders on the storm. There's a killer on the road.